Bennett Davison here with the Euro Hoop Life podcast. We're going to be talking to Coach Vladimir Bozniak. Coach, how you doing today?
Hi, Bennett. I'm doing okay. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Outstanding. So let's dig right into this. We're going to talk about basketball in the Ivory Coast, how the African Basketball League through FIBA, and now that in Rwanda, the NBA Africa is coming in and they are funding and getting things organized. We're going to talk in the details because you probably are very up to date on those details. Give me your experience of when you got there, how it was, what you expected, what you knew. Give me the intro of how you got in contact with the Ivory Coast Basketball League. And what was the team name?
As you know from the other sources, in 2011 happened so-called Arab Spring in Middle East. So many countries which did have a market for basketball, having basketball and other things, got in some kind of the political turbulence, and some got in even civil. Anyway, 2010 from Syria, where I was coaching the Al-Wahda team, and I was a coach of national team, I was moving to Ivory Coast, and that was first country, we call that from the Black Africa, real Africa, Africa which we first get in the mind when we mention that name. That was the one beautiful country. They already participated two times in a World Cup, but that was the first time there. Before, they were in the 1980s, but that's not now relevant for you. The most important thing is that 2010, when I went to the Côte d'Ivoire, or Ivory Coast, that was the city name is Abidjan, and that's very big city, and more like French colonial outlook, and many African citizens from the North Africa, from the Sub-Sahara area, they're getting there because of the economical issues.
Morocco and all.
Exactly. In football, they have from Mali, from Burkina Faso, from many other countries from the north. But in any case, they have a very strong football, especially Didier Drogba is one of the most famous football soccer players. Like Michael Jordan was, or Magic Johnson was in basketball, that guy was in football. And of course, he was playing everywhere around the world. And another story is they do have many basketball players who play out of Ivory Coast, in France, in Belgium, in Switzerland, and even in many colleges in United States.
Yeah, the basketball IQ and talent is getting a lot better. So when you got there in the Arab Spring and the city was good, what was the whole situation? What was it like getting there coaching? What were the facilities like? What would a player expect if they were playing under you as a coach?
My suggestion, whoever is coming to any country, such as a country which you Americans are considering like a turbulent country, you have first to see if you're up to the facility. Sometimes you have to play outdoor. You have to play outdoor. You cannot have always indoor facilities. So first you have to know that. But there's another story. You have to see also, do they recently have some African club championship, anything to organize, because if they do, they put the wood on the floor, so then, you know, they have a good indoor facility. Like now, Rwanda has a beautiful arena with 10,000 spectators. So that's something new and something really significant.
Looking forward
to. Yes. Another story you have to know is electricity. If you really want to come to this kind of countries, and you're getting some living place, if it's not hotel. Yeah. And my advice is always, if you take hotel, if club is ready to pay you, you take hotel which has aggregates. If you have an aggregate, which means they can, when you lose electricity, unfortunately, the weak spot when we talk about Africa is electricity.
Constant
many times
energy.
Goes off, yes. So, you know, then they switch on the aggregate. So you, after that, you can again have electricity. Okay. And that helps you in many, many ways, especially when you live in that tropical, areas where the humility and humility is so, so high. So this is the first thing I would like always to suggest to you guys. Also, the most important thing you have to know is very simply, you have to take all those medicine against malaria, okay, because our immunity is much lower than local citizens. Yeah. And you know what? If you have electricity, you can put plug in the wall those anti-mosquito things at such a time. Yes.
So that's the worst case situation. Those are the worst things you have to prepare for. How's the basketball over there? And when you were there, you had something to share about how now NBA Africa is taking over the league.
Basketball is good. There are many good athletes, strong, movable, great fitness, great footwork, very jumpable. They love to play basketball. If you give them today some individual drill, some workout, tomorrow, if you come sooner in the practice, you see that some of those guys are practicing the drill you give them yesterday. Those kind of things you cannot find everywhere around the world.
They're hungry. They look for something better. Basketball is their passion.
They are looking to get better. They want to be better.
Yeah.
I admire them for that. Another story is when we talk about ball, they already tried several times. They had 2016, I was in Gabon, in Libreville. They tried, also nice city, replica of the French cities. They tried to make Africa Basketball League, but that didn't work out because too many local people were involved, and they tried to get their own private benefits. This time, Ball Basketball Africa League is getting...
The money never made it to the end designation. People are always taking their hands on it.
People sometimes think that there is no tomorrow, you know.
Yeah.
They don't believe in a long-time investment, whatever you can get. And they're not guilty because, unfortunately, many things are changing here over the nights. Rwanda was 26 years ago, very, very bad place for living because of all those civil war and genocide things. But today, Rwanda is a Switzerland. As Dean told you, it's Africa Switzerland. So really, in many ways, Rwanda is a level, when we talk about security, about health issues and other things around the West European country.
Awesome. So when you got there, so now with NBA Africa, how is this going to be organized? Let's take like 1 minute and go about how NBA is going to, because it sounds like Rwanda is maybe the epicenter where they're going to start the NBA Africa. Is that correct?
Well, should be many other countries. Angola, for example, was in the last 20-something years winning 7 African basketball championships when you talk about national teams.
Yeah.
Angola also has a huge, huge facility. Beautiful players who were playing many times on Olympic Games, in World Cups. But, you know, also their situation is not that stable like is in Rwanda. Here, basically, you have much more safer neighborhoods. People are not scared of any crime on the street. So from that reason, I'm sure that in the future, Rwanda would be host much more than any other country because of this kind of situations. For example, we should play basketball league, which is something mixed between the tournament and between the league. We would not have every, like in Spain, you play from Napoli, and now you go to Valencia.
Yeah.
After Valencia, you go back to Napoli, then you go to Athens. This is not a way they would play the league. They would, in a certain cities, have hosting the
window. I see. Because they don't have as many facilities.
Yes. And they try to bring 5 teams and to play one round in one city, another round in another city, and after several exchange games, tournament type of the games, like a group in a World Cup.
The NCAA tournament instead of like the EuroLeague.
They try to do something in between, then to get to the final 8 or final 4, it's dependable how they would organize that, then it would happen in a host city.
Yeah.
This year should be Rwanda. Next time, I don't know, somebody else. Or again, as I told you, China is always capable to be host. So.
Yeah. We'll see how it goes. Yeah, it's like trying to transfer a large golf tournament. It's like, hey, here are all the sponsors. Here's the locations. And no, it's awesome how they're trying to do new things. I think it's something good. It's just kind of like this, the G League. Then you have the G League premium or premier, and then you have college, and then you have like prep school. So there's kind of like they're expanding. I think basketball, just the more opportunities and the structure that they can set them up, it sounds like it, if it can work, start in three, let's build four. And each year you're expanding and becoming more. I think those national teams and a national pastime is so good for starting up and industrializing a country, because you need that spirit that brings people together when it's not politics and finances, but something where you can get a release and
certainly
somewhere else.
And many, many destinies, many, 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 many people would have more choices to develop in their lives, basketball players, their families, etc., etc. You know, people can make a fortune out of that.
Outstanding. Coach, well, I'll leave your name. I just wanted to – this is a great amount of information. I'm going to put it up on YouTube and a couple of our different Facebook pages. Coach Vladimir Bozniak, find him on a Facebook Messenger or LinkedIn. That's how we've been communicating. And it's probably 2 o'clock where you're at right now.
Now it's almost midnight. It's not 2 o'clock. It's almost midnight.
Well, it's afternoon. Always. It's five o'clock. I'm going to go have a beer, and I want you to enjoy the rest of your day.
You look like that you don't drink a beer. You look like that you're on a blender all the time.
I still got to play a little bit of basketball.
I can tell that you're a basketball player. Wish you all the best. Say hi to your family and see you soon.
Coach, bye-bye. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.